Hey guys, welcome back, GTS. I've got Jules here again. And Julian, face me real quick, yeah? So as we can see, as I try to zoom in on this thing, Julian's right shoulder is lower than his left. That's actually something quite common. We call that, in layman terms, handiness. And basically, the dominant shoulder, the scapula that we say, the shoulder bone in your back for you non-anatomical people, can sit lower than the non-dominant. So it's pretty obvious by looking at his, well, right shoulder technically was lower about 2 minutes ago, but he's been playing around with this ball, so now I think his left shoulder is lower. But either way, it's irrelevant, because what we're going to have him, Julian, do is he's going to take that ball in his hand, which he's going to show us right now, exactly, and he's going to roll it around on his right shoulder, which will then put the scapula back where we want it, and he's just going to show everybody a really good way that you can release basically your upper neck musculature, which is like right around in there. So you've got your big trapezius, your levator scapula, which is right there, your scalenes that sit and pull on your first rib, which is right there, basically around the clavicle region, which is, for you non-anatomical people, that is the clavicle right there. And these are the muscles that cause a lot of pain in your neck and actually can cause pain down mid in your thoracic region of your back if not taken care of, because the trapezius, the very big one on top, connects all the way down to basically the mid-level of your back. So all you computer people sitting in the office, or athletes playing massive amounts of sports, basically everybody under the sun is going to get tightness in that area. So we are going to have Jules show you the drill against a round pull, because we don't have a square one. Everybody else, try to find something similar that is not round, because this makes it a bit... Luckily, Julian's talented, so he's going to show us how he does it, and he's going to do it well. So pressure's not on. Don't let the ball drop, because if it does, everybody will laugh. Here we are. So he's just going to kind of act as if he's going to rugby hit the wall, for you non-American football players here. And he's just going to kind of roll around. I'm going to try to see if I can zoom in here. Basically right on that muscle belly in here. And then Jules, why don't you go ahead and put your arm behind your back a bit. He's going to roll around. And basically any which way he can change the area in which the muscle is being massaged, if you will. As you can see, the ball slides out a bit. It's not the best to do it on a round pull. But like I said, he's one of our more academically talented people here, so we see if he can figure it out. All right, cool. Now you can see he moved the ball a bit, and he's going up more into his neck. And Julian, why don't you go ahead and take your arm through some, through the basic range of motion, like go into forward flexion. There you go. So we can have him, there you go, exactly, move his arm basically in any which way he wants, and then he can feel the muscle itself move under the ball. So let's do this for about, 10 more seconds, and then hopefully he's going to stand up, and I don't look like that much of an idiot, and his right shoulder is going to be sitting lower than his left again, because like I said, he was playing around a bit before and made me look kind of funny. So, Jules, how's that feeling, man? Is that a bit tight?
Yes.
Okay. Well, yeah, it slipped out. That's fine. Let's go ahead and have you stand up. And go ahead and just stand a bit normal there. Ah, look at that. Okay, cool. I don't look as crazy. You can see the distance basically between his ear, I point to it right there, and his shoulder. And then I switch hands, his other ear and his shoulder. There's a massive drop between the right side compared to the left. So we could obviously do the left side now, and that would also drop. But we're already at 4 minutes, which I think is long enough. However, rewind back to the beginning of the video, and just so you see that I'm not crazy, it was the exact opposite. His left shoulder was actually sitting lower than his right. And Jules, you're right-handed, yeah?
Yeah.
There you go. So we're back to the situation of handiness, which is where the right scapula on Jules, because he's right-handed, should be sitting a bit lower. So again, rewind it, watch it. We use a pretty fancy little ball that I paid way too much money for. However, I zoom in. You can get this actually on its.de. But if you want a lacrosse ball, for you people in North America that can buy those, and for people in Germany, it's a bit tough, you can use a tennis ball. Lacrosse ball is a bit better because it's harder, but a tennis ball will also do the trick. So hope that worked out, guys. Jules, thanks. I'm glad your right shoulder feels better. We can now turn the camera off and do your left. All right, guys, thanks so much. See you next.